Good morning, KO Kids. Listen, today is a day that the Lord has made. So we are going to rejoice and be glad in it because today's a what, y'all? Today's a gift. You get gifts that aren't even on Christmas because today is a gift and it's a gift from God. I am so excited that you guys are here to worship with us this morning. Listen, this is our last Sunday in this series. We've been doing this series called Hey God. Y'all remember that? Hey God. Yeah, today we're going to wrap that up and next week we're going to start something brand new. So before we get started, what I want us to do is go ahead and stand to your feet. Come on, stretch if you got to stretch. Lift those hands up and to the side. Are you doing it? Lift them to the front, to the back, and stretch out. And we are going to worship God. Our first song is a really fun song. It's called Brighter Day by Kirk Franklin. Y'all know that song? I think some of you might know it. So let's go ahead and get into that song right now.
Yo, everybody, come get your bounce on, get your bounce on, get your bounce on. Don't be cute with it, you gotta get, come on. Fifth ward, fourth ward. Come on, sing it.
Listen, I love that song. I love Brighter Day, Brighter Day. It's a fun song. And this next song, as you guys know, our Hey God series has been about prayer and knowing that we can talk to God, right? Well, there's a special prayer that is actually in scripture. And then there was a song that was written about it, and it's called The Blessing. And we are going to worship and just sing The Blessing. And what we're doing is that we've taken a prayer and we have put it into song form, okay? So here's what I need you to do. I need you to just lift your hands to the Lord as you sing this song, okay? All right.
favor be upon you in the thousand generation, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you in the thousand generation, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and the thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and the thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his
So we just sang the blessing. We put that prayer into song form. And the wonderful thing about that is that that reminds us that we can talk to God. That's what this whole series has been about, right? Yeah, we said, hey, God, come on, tell him hey. He's listening to you. Say, hey, God. That's right. And so we've learned that we can talk to God. We can talk to him about anything. We can talk to him at any time, right? Well, this morning, for our very last lesson, what we're going to learn is that we can talk to God anywhere. Say, I can talk to God anywhere. That's right. You can talk to God anywhere. It doesn't matter. You see, a lot of us think that the only times that we can talk to God is whenever we get on our knees before we go to bed to say our prayers. And then whenever we say the grace before we eat. Yeah, those are great times to talk. But guess what? Your bed and at the dinner table are two places, but how about whenever you're walking down the street? Can you talk to God then? Yes. Let me ask you this question. Do you talk to God then? Ah, that's a question that we have to look at. It's not just that you can, it's that we should. Even adults, we have to realize that we can talk to God anywhere at any time. As a matter of fact, one of the best models of knowing how to pray is who? Come on, say it out loud. Who is it? Jesus. That's right. And there are several scriptures that talk about just how Jesus just prayed anywhere. As a matter of fact, in the book of Luke, chapter 5, starting at verse 15, it says, "Yet the news about him spread all the more, so that the crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sickness." So people came from all over to see Jesus. And then verse 16 says, "But Jesus often withdrew to a lonely place and prayed." You see, for Jesus, it was better for him if he prayed by himself, not around a lot of people. Why did he do that? Well, he did that just so he could focus only on talking to the Father, right? And then in the book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 35, it says, "Very early in the morning," and we learned recently that we could talk to God at any time, right? So this is very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went to a solitary place where he prayed. So Jesus even left the house that he was at to then go to another place where he was by himself to pray. Here's the thing, kids. If that's our model, if we look and we want to do what Jesus did, then why don't we, one, pray, and two, we can do it in a quiet place, right? Where there's not a lot of noise, not a lot of distractions. And so then there's this other Bible story in the book of Acts, chapter 12, and it's verses 1 through 17. I won't read it all. But just to kind of tell you guys what's happening, there is a disciple. Do you guys know what a disciple is? A disciple is a follower of Jesus. And at this point, while Jesus was still on the earth, he had 12. And then we know that he told those disciples to go out and make more disciples, right? But one of the 12 disciples, his name was Peter. He was doing what Jesus had taught him to do, to go out and make other disciples. But in this day, that was illegal. So he got arrested. He had to go to jail for talking about Jesus and spreading the good news and teaching them even how to pray. And so whenever Peter went to jail, all of his family and his friends, they were sad that he went to jail. But you know what they did whenever they were sad? They prayed. They said, "Hey, God, our friend Peter is in jail. God, please help and deliver him." And they kept praying and they kept praying and they kept praying. And then guess what happened? You guys are never going to believe this. God sent an angel to the jail. And Peter was asleep. But whenever he was asleep, he was between two of the guards. So he had a police guard on this side and a police guard on this side. And they were asleep. But the angel told Peter to get up, put on the clothes, and leave. And with God's help, because God listened to the prayers, Peter left the jail. And whenever he went back to the home of his family and friends, he knocked on the door. And everybody was like, "What's going on?" They were surprised, but what they realized is that God really does answer prayer. And so, kids, through this entire series, what we've learned is that we can talk to God about anything. We can do it any way that we want to. We can do it at any time, and we can do it anywhere. But the most important thing to remember is that we can talk to God. So as you guys just got done with the Team 21 fast, you spent 21 days of doing devotionals, of praying, right? Of listening to what the Lord has to say. Well, don't let that ever stop. We should always pray. We should always want to read our Bibles. Even if we can have cake, even if we can have video games, we should still pray to God. Do you remember our big verse from this entire series? Do you? If not, I'll remind you. Remember Philippians 4 and 6. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. You tell God what you need and thank Him for all that He has done. So as we close up this series called, Hey God, do not forget to never worry about anything, but always pray about everything. Come on, say, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. That's right. And as you tell God what you need and thank Him for what He has done, you will see Him answer your prayers. You'll see Him still talk to you, okay? So here's what I need you to do as we close out this series. Go to www.nakeochurch.com/kidsresources. And there you will find today's activity sheet, okay? Okay, now, I have something else to tell you. We are picking up our stuff. We're gonna pack our suitcases because we're moving. Parents, hey, parents, if you're listening, come to the screen. Grandparents, aunties, uncles, whoever set this up today. Guess what? Nakeo Kids is moving. Yeah, this Sunday is our last Sunday that we will be streaming here on the Nakeo Church YouTube platform. Why? Well, Nakeo Kids now has their own YouTube channel. Yeah, we got our own channel. That is right. So you can find all of the videos from past Sunday services and from videos from the kids resources on our Nakeo Kids YouTube page. Every Sunday service to come will solely be streamed on the Nakeo Kids YouTube page. So how do you find it? You go to that search bar and you type in Nakeo Kids. And then you will see a page that comes up with our new Nakeo Kids logo. And then you'll see a button, and it's a plus button, and it says subscribe. Make sure you subscribe. Why do you subscribe? Well, you do that so that way you can have notifications of whenever we posted a new video and whenever we have our services posted on Sunday mornings, okay? And it'll make it a lot easier so you don't have to search every single week. So here's what I need you to do, parents. As you are getting the activity sheets, go ahead to that search bar, type in Nakeo Kids, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, okay? So don't come back to the Nakeo Church page next Sunday looking for me, because we won't be here because Nakeo Kids has moved, okay? Nakeo Kids YouTube page, we cannot wait to see you guys over there. So as you guys are finishing up, as your parents are finding this new YouTube page, as you are doing your activity sheets, remember, parents and kids alike, not to worry about anything, but instead pray about everything. Tell God what it is that you need and thank Him for all He has done. And then watch how a simple, hey God, can make every week the best week of your life.